Hi everyone, welcome to another episode of Medical Educational Video by Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming and I'm a family physician practicing in Singapore. Cancer is a serious problem that is increasingly worrying as the incidence in Singapore is rising. Do you know what are the top 3 cancers in Singapore? Do you know if you fall under the high risk group for these cancers? What are the screening tests available and what are the symptoms for these cancers? I will be sharing more in this 2 video series on cancer. Please click on the subscribe and notification button now if you haven't already done so. Thanks for your support. This is the first of the 2 videos, so let's get down to it now. Based on Singapore Cancer Society data, 2013 to 2017 mortality data, about 39 people are diagnosed with cancer and 15 people die of cancer every day. 1 in 4 may develop cancer in their lifetime. The good news is, with early detection and management, you can have better clinical outcomes. The top 3 cancers in men are colorectal cancer, lung cancer, and prostate cancer. The top 3 cancers in women are breast cancer, colorectal, and lung cancer. So let's talk about lung cancer now. What are the risk factors for lung cancer? Cigarette smoke is the number one risk factor for lung cancer. In fact, secondhand smoke is also a major risk factor of lung cancer among non-smokers. Secondhand smoke actually increases the risk of lung cancer by 30%. Age. Lung cancer is more common in people above the age of 40. Personal or family history. Your risk of lung cancer is higher if someone in your family have had lung cancer before. A lung cancer survivor may develop another form of lung cancer again. Fourthly, air pollution. The World Health Organization estimates that there are about 4 million excess deaths per year worldwide due to air pollution. Those who live in more polluted cities have higher risk of lung cancer than those who live in less polluted cities. The scary thing is that there are often no symptoms in the early stages. In the later stages, you may get unexplained weight loss and tiredness, loss of appetite, persistent cough with blood in the sputum, breathlessness, chest pain, fever, and chest infections. The most effective method to reduce the risk of lung cancer is to avoid smoking totally. At the moment, there is still no population-wide screening test for lung cancer available. Let's talk about colorectal cancer now. The risk factors are your age. Elderly above 50 are at a higher risk of colorectal cancer. Ethnicity, Chinese have a higher risk of colorectal cancer. Personal history, individuals who have polyps in their colons or who were diagnosed with colorectal cancer before are at a higher risk of developing recurrences. Fourthly, family history. Your risk of colorectal cancer is higher if you have relatives who suffered from it. If you have a rare inherited disease called familial polyposis, a condition where you may have hundreds of polyps in your colon, then you are almost certainly going to develop colorectal cancer later in your life. Sedentary lifestyle and obesity has also been linked with increased risk of colorectal cancer. Dietary habits. Research has identified certain factors which can increase your risk of colorectal cancer. Alcohol, processed meat, red meat increases your risk while fruits and vegetables reduces your risk. Again, like lung cancer, colorectal cancer can have no symptoms at an early stage. However, warning signs that you should look out for includes blood in your stool, low blood count or anemia, abdominal pain or discomfort, feeling a hard lump in your abdomen, change in bowel habits. For example, some people may report that the motion is getting thinner, or some may say that they're actually getting constipation. Thankfully, there are now screening tests available to detect early stage colorectal cancer for people aged above 50. There are 2 ways you can do it. The first one is via a FEAT kit, fecal immunochemical test kit. This is a simple test that detects microscopic amounts of blood in your stool. This test can be done at the comfort of your home. If blood is detected in your stool, then we will need to refer the patients for further evaluations and examination to exclude the possibility of cancer. The second way is via colonoscopy. This is recommended also once every 5 years for people age 50 and above. You can do either of the two screening tests. So we have reached the end of this video. In the next video, we will be discussing about breast cancer in females and prostate cancer in men. Again, please click on the subscribe and notification button to receive updates when we release new videos. Stay tuned for episode 2 next week. Till the next time, stay safe, stay healthy.